Welcome to Chawla's Kitchen. Today I'm gonna make a very special dish. It's a malai kofta. Everybody loves it. If I go to a restaurant anytime, I order either for kadai paneer or malai kofta. So it's a rich dish made out of kareem and koftas that is made out of paneer, that is cottage cheese and some potatoes. So let's see the ingredients and we can make this at home. It's not very difficult, very easy. So let's see what ingredients I need for it. So here are my ingredients. I'll be using two potatoes which I have already boiled and peeled. So I'll be just mashing it, and here is the scrambled or grated, whatever you can say, homemade paneer I have. So I'll be putting both of this along with, I'll be using some corn flour over here. I have a corn flour just to roll our bowls, and in our bowls I'll be putting this some cashews, some raisins and some almonds. So I'll cut it that into small pieces and I'll just put that and make koftas out of it. And for our gravy, we need some onions, around one medium sized onion I have over here, which I have already cut. Some ginger, around an inch of ginger. Some garlic, around 3 tablespoons of garlic you can say. So around 5 to 6 cloves of garlic. Some jeera, if you have Shah jeera you can say, you can use that. I'm just using a normal jeera. Some cilantro and condiments. I need some salt, some turmeric powder, some garam masala along with some red chili powder, and yes, I need puree also. So I'm using this crushed tomato puree. We can get it at any supermarket. So I got this from Sam's. So I'll be using around 1.5 cup of this puree along with cream. So heavy whipping cream will go into it. So let's get started. I'll be making koftas first and then I'll be making gravy out of it. Here I have mashed potatoes. I'm just using my hand to mash the potatoes. You can use anything. So here goes a paneer, cottage cheese. So first I'll make a balls and I'll see if I need corn flour to, you know, just rub the balls. I'll see, because if it would be quite a moisture, then I'll use cornstarch. Otherwise I'll just skip that process. Just mix everything well. Here goes around 1/2 teaspoon of almonds, around 1/2 teaspoon of cashews, some raisins, then again mix well. Let me put salt, some salt, around a pinch of salt I would say, and some garam masala. Mix well with your hands because we want all the masalas and everything to blend well in our mixture. So all the balls are ready. Look at here. And I haven't used any corn flour, and I'll not pat, you know, just dust it with the corn flour because I have a good binding because of paneer. So let's get started. My oil is already heated up over here in the pan. So here goes the balls. So I'm actually shallow frying it. If you guys can, you know, want, you can deep fry it. It actually fastens the process. And moreover, if you feel your balls are really have a lot of moisture, then use corn flour. Otherwise, just skip that. And generally, when you need to skip that, if you will put more paneer. So it takes some time to get cooked, to get fried. So I'll put it on between medium to high heat for a while and just turn the sides. Look, isn't it looking beautiful? So I'm just turning all the sides. So I hope it will take probably 5 to 10 minutes to get it cooked. So here are my koftas ready. It's really beautiful, and let's start making a gravy over here. So I'm using the same pan. I have some oil heated up here. Here goes cumin seeds. Just stir this until it gets spluttered. Then we'll be using our all purees. Ginger puree along with garlic puree. Here goes my ginger and garlic puree. Give it a stir. Here goes my onion paste. So puree, whatever you are using, we like to have a puree sort of stuff in this. That's the reason I am using everything pureed. So some people, what they do, they put everything as, you know, cut down pieces and then they puree that thing. But we Punjabis really don't like that way. First we cook everything this way, like a puree form. Then we'll be making a gravy stuff and put our malai kofta in it. So I'll give it like 5 minutes to get it cooked, then we'll put our tomatoes in it. So my onions are done. It took me around 5 minutes, so all the raw flavor has gone. So here goes the tomatoes. So just want to tell you guys, for 2 potatoes along with 1 cup of paneer, I have made around 15 koftas. And for that, I have used around, I told you guys, around 1.5 cup of tomatoes. So at this point of time, I'm just going to cover this with the lid and then we'll put the condiments in it. But we will cook this for around 5 to 10 minutes until it leaves oil from the sides. Then we will put our condiments along with the cream in it. So my tomatoes are done. I gave it like 15 to 20 minutes. We really love, you know, all tomatoes and onions to get cooked well. That's the reason we Punjabis really cook our food for a long time. And here goes my cashew paste. So I have used around some cashews, around 3, like I would say around 1/2 teaspoon of cashews along with some almonds. And I've made paste out of it. Here, now I'll put my condiments. Here goes salt. According to your taste, I'm using around 1 teaspoon of salt. Some red chili powder. Red chili powder you can adjust according to your taste. I'm just using a pinch. Some haldi powder. Around 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala. Again, mix everything well. And now put some water in it. So I'm putting around 1/2 cup of water in it. I'll get it cooked for 5 more minutes. And then we'll put our cream. So this is cooking for around 5 minutes now. And cashew and all, everything has been blended well with the masala. So here goes a main ingredient. That's a cream. So around 1/2 cup of cream in it. So just stir this well and I'll cook this again for another 5 minutes and then our gravy is ready and we will put just our koftas in it. So I gave like 5 to 10 minutes, good 10 minutes to get this cream cooked along with the gravy. So look at this, we don't want it to be very thin and we want it to be somewhat thicker. So this should be the consistency and now I'm just gonna turn off my heat. Now put this koftas in it. And moreover, I want to tell you guys, because I am making it for my home use, so I have not used any whole garam masalas. If you are using it for some party or something, just use garam masalas like bay leaf, some cloves and some green cardamom. That will really, you know, give a good flavor to this dish. So that's it, my koftas are done. So just garnish with this with some cilantro over here and it's ready to serve. So here I have garnished it with some grated cheese, grated paneer you can say. And you know, if you really like this recipe, just don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe on our channel to know more videos. And really, if you like this recipes, watch my another recipes, authentic recipes, Punjabi recipes. And don't forget to share this with your friends too. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.